Create for me, O God, give me back the joy of your salvation.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there in the Jerusalem, at the Sheep Gate, a pool called in Hebrew Bethesda, with five porticos. There lay a large number of ill, blind, lame, and crippled. One man who was there had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had been ill for a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be healed? And do you want to be well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no one to put me into the pool. When the water stirred up, while I am on my way, someone else gets down there before me." Jesus said to him, "Rise up, take up your mat and walk." Immediately the man became well, took up his mat and walked. Now that day was a Sabbath, so the Jews said to the man who was cured, "It is Sabbath, and it is not lawful for you to carry your mat." He answered them, "The man who made me well told me, 'Take up your mat and walk.'" And they asked him, "Who is the man who told you, 'Take it up and walk?'" The man who was healed did not know who it was, for Jesus had slipped away since there was a crowd there. After this, Jesus found him in the temple area and said to him, "Look, you are now well, and do not sin anymore, so that nothing worse will happen to you." The man went and told the Jews that Jesus was the one who healed and made him well. Therefore, the Jews began to persecute Jesus because he did this on a Sabbath. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mr. Rason, awariya may chief. Pwedeng mag-assist ka dun sa may, parang may matandang naka-wheelchair dun sa labas. Assist mo silang makapasok. Assist mo. Swapan nyo lang makalo. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good evening.
Good evening po, Amo.
In Israel, there are two interesting two bodies of water. Yung isa, tawag nila Dead Sea, patay na dagat. In fact, it is a lake more than a sea, lawa. And then the other is Sea of Galilee, kung saan nangingisda si na Pedro. At doon sila nakakuha ng maraming isda. Anong pagkakaiba ng dalawa? Bakit yung isa, dead, patay, Dead Sea, and the other one is flourishing with water and life? Una, tingnan muna natin kung saan ang gagaling yung the Sea of Galilee. The Jordan River originates from Mount Hermon, flowing through the plains into northern Israel, eventually reaching the Sea of Galilee. After the Sea of Galilee is exiting, it continues south and reaches its endpoint, natatapos at the Dead Sea. Para bang nanggagaling dun sa ilog ng Jordan, sa bundok ng Hermon, dadaan sa may Sea of Galilee, tapos matatapos dun sa Dead Sea. The Dead Sea is notable to be the lowest point. Kaya nga, Dead Sea is actually a lake. It's not a sea. Another significant body of water along with Jordan River's path, the Sea of Galilee. The lake is almost 13 kilometers long and 7 miles wide. Known for its abundant fish population, lush foliage surrounding it, which is the largest freshwater lake in Israel, celebrated in its vibrant ecosystem and scenic beauty. Parang ito yung first reading, di ba? Yung first reading natin, it's about the flowing river na naging malalim, puno ng buhay, puno ng isda, ang daming nakikinabang. The Dead Sea, on the other hand, is a body of water stretching 50 miles in length and 11 miles in width. Ang laki nitong Dead Sea, with its shoreline situated to 1,300 feet below sea level. Napakalalim. Talagang malalim po siya. And pag dumating yung tubig doon, di na makakalabas. Nakakakuha ng tubig from Sea of Galilee and Jordan River, pero walang lumalabas. Tumatanggap ng tubig, pero walang ninalabasan yung tubig. Kasi napakalalim niya from sea level. The Dead Sea is stagnant, acting as a dead end where the water does not flow out anymore. This condition, combined with its extremely high salt content, means no life can be sustained by the water. Sobrang maalat yung tubig doon. Kaya nga, kahit isda, hindi nabubuhay. At kung may nabubuhay na isda doon, parang abnormal kasi it's too salty. Waters do not flow. It only receives water. Water without an outlet tend to become murky. This stagnation can result to fish that have murky taste. Bali yan po itang may katakman ako pong asa na maumok. Maumok. Then asa na maumok, di sila masarap. Parang expression sa Pampangan, lalasa lang, burak. Because they did not live in fresh waters. Kaya yung lasa nila, lasang putik in a sense. As lack of water flow prevents natural cleansing, renewal of the water's properties. Therefore, water flows in and water flows out, gives light to the Sea of Galilee and even Jordan River. Conversely, the Dead Sea only receives water but does not have an outlet, leading to stagnant conditions where water does not circulate and renew anymore. This stagnation prevents life from being supported by the Dead Sea. Patay na. We understand that even as we receive, we should also give back. Pag tumatanggap ka, anuman tong grasya, dapat dumaan din sa iyo. Pag natalo lang sa iyo, natapos lang sa iyo ang grasya, ang tawag sa iyo, Dead Sea. Walang buhay na mamantili sa iyo, walang mabubuhay. Wala kang masusuportahan, wala kang matutulungan kasi natapos lang ang grasya sa iyo. The Jordan River is a continuous flow into the Sea of Galilee. It serves as source of life for so many. This flow symbolizes the importance of allowing that as we receive to pass through us, as we receive graces to pass through us, akin to fresh flow of grace. The result of a vibrant environment adorned with lavish and lush greenery, fruitful trees, abundant fish, teeming with life. Ang kabaligtaran naman, the Dead Sea. When we receive without sharing, we resemble the Dead Sea. Tumatanggap tayo pero wala nang lumalabas sa tinanggap natin. Natatapos sa atin, baka inuubos din natin, tinatago natin. The Dead Sea is unable to support life. It is stagnant, it is dead, it is murky. This analogy underscores the significance of sharing and allowing goodness we receive to flow through us, fostering life and vitality around, supporting life. Kaya nga siguro, ito ang invitation sa atin. May we become the Jordan River or even the Sea of Galilee. punong-puno ng isda, punong-puno ng buhay, mga halaman, may bunga, halaman na ginagamit pagkain ng mga tao, isda kinakain ng mga tao, mga halaman, even the first reading, nagiging gamot sa mga tao. The flowing water brings blessings, and the flowing grace enables, while failure to share graces and blessings disables. Naway tayo ay maging lugar na mga pinanggagaling, pinagdadaluyan ng grasya. May tinatanggap tayo, naway dumadaan din sa atin ang kabutihan at grasyang tinatanggap natin upang tunay nga tayo magbigay ng buhay. Hindi tayo nagiging dead sea. May God bless us all. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.